Last week, as you recall, we left Will and Penny peacefully birdwatching, unaware that high above them, a passing spaceship was about to hurl an incredible visitor down upon their forgotten planet.
Hold it. This looks like a good place. Martha, here, let me look for a while.
You just take down the description. I'll do the bird watching.
It's not fair. I always get the dull job.
Look, I'm the man around here, and men give the orders.
Just because you tried to shave this morning doesn't mean you're a man. Why, look at you. All you managed to cut off is a big hunk of skin.
Look, I told you I was just practicing. I didn't know there was a blade and a razor.
Well, why didn't you take the time to look, silly?
Every time I let you come along with me, it's the same old story. Nag, nag, nag.
Well, if you'd let me use the binoculars once in a while, the habit pattern would be different.
The habit pattern would be different. Oh, listen to her.
Well, why don't you let me use the glasses? My eyes are just as good as yours are.
Because you exaggerate everything, that's why. The neck is angular, with a gentle pink band running around its base. The legs are slender, graceful, with a delicate... Sounds more like you're describing a fashion show than a bird specimen.
You're just jealous because I have a better command of words than you do.
Baloney! My vocabulary of words is just as good as yours.
It is not.
You want to bet? Yeah.
If you'll permit me to speak, both of you have an excellent command of the English language. However, if you do not contain yourselves, you will frighten off a specimen which has just arrived.
Where? I don't see anything.
A few feet to the right of the small tree.
Oh, isn't it beautiful? All right, now I'm ready.
We've already cataloged that one. It's a plump-bellied Dr. Smith sapsucker.
But I don't understand. Well, here's a golden-tailed Dr. Smith wine dotty and a Dr. Smith bullfinch.
An explanation is simple. Dr. Smith names all the specimens which he discovers after himself.
That's why I don't ask him to come with me anymore.
Otherwise, every bird on this planet would have Dr. Smith as part of his name.
Spaceship, they're throwing something out of there.
Come on, Will, we better get back to the Jupiter, too.
It's luggage, trunks, and suitcases.
Warning! 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 Approaching danger!
Parachute on that trike didn't open.
So I see. The robot. He saved my life.
Will! Penny! Are you all right? Are you all right?
Yeah. If it hadn't been for you, I would have been killed.
I have been programmed to protect others. I only performed as required. Also, you are my friend.
And you're mine.
Hey, I wonder what's in this trunk.
There's one way to find out. Let's open it.
Oh. Cards, dice, I've never seen so many gambling things.
I wonder who they belong to. Over there.
Computations reveal no serious injuries.
He's probably just stunned from the fall.
Are you all right?
Oh, we're fine, sir. But I'm not too sure about him.
We saw the spaceship as it passed overhead.
He must have parachuted out of it. All these things must belong to him.
Oh, seems to be coming too.
I wonder what he's doing here. Well, at least he looks pleasant enough. Not like some horrible growling monster.
He's alive! Penny!
What's the matter with Smith?
Oh, he looks absolutely terrified.
How do you feel?
He probably doesn't understand our language.
Of course I understand English, young man.
Who are you, sir?